Good. Single best chart today. Let's do that with Tobias Lefkovich right now with City Group. This is the chart we showed last week. Tobias knows this chart cold. It's the Ibbotson chart. In this case, we're showing Standard & Poor's 500. Slope matters. It's logged the depression in the 30s over on the left. And I put some circles there of kisses. These are kisses. These are moving averages which show that all the doom and the gloom that's out there is baloney. We've got one here, Tobias. Got another one up here. What's wrong with buy and hold?
In today's hedge fund dominated week-to-week performance world, that's the problem. You have lots of the traditional buy and hold investors who've held back and they've not participated in this market. And I'm not talking about the last year or two. They haven't participated since 2009. They've missed this more than tripling of the market.
So what does that mean? What does that mean for the mood of the market into the summer, into the autumn as well?
I think there's a potential for positive surprise because they're already anticipating weakness. They're already worried about a whole host of issues, including elections abroad, which is what we were worried about a month or two or three ago. But they moved on from the Netherlands to, you know, to France, et cetera. And I think investors continue to find things to worry about, which is not the type of environment where markets peak out.
Which sector do you like best?
Financials are one of them,
and
energy is another one that I'd probably be picking up here, as investors have kind of abandoned them.